Hello and welcome to our presentation. My name is Craig and I'll be working today with Tatiana. We'll be collaborating on an open app dev tool chain to show you how we can interact with ZOS and a COBOL program. Obviously, I'm a more seasoned ZOS professional, so I'll be using some traditional tools that help me interact with my COBOL and with the other components. And these will help us interact both with ZOS and with the open tools. And Tatiana, as the newer programmer, will be working with the new tools from different interfaces. So let's get started. As you can see, I'm on a repository here where I have source code stored. This would be something like a GitHub, or you could use Bitbucket. We're actually using a Bitbucket repository today. And you can see I have access to multiple projects here. We'll be working with the COBOL example project today. So you can see here we have several components. We have some build JCL that we'll be working with, and then our COBOL program. And we'll be working, collaborating today, making some changes to our COBOL program, testing them, and then pushing them through the DevOps tool chain. So with that, Tatiana, I'll turn things over to you.
Thank you, Craig. I'm a developer who is not comfortable with green screen. So I use VS Code, which is one of the modern IDEs. In this project, we work with COBOL code, with makefiles and JCLs. VS Code has numerous extensions for syntax highlighting and auto-completion for different languages and different types of the files. Also, VS Code has Zoe Explorer. It is an extension that can allow users to connect to ZOS and work with datasets, USS files, and manage jobs from your IDE. First of all, I want to obtain source code at my USS environment. VS Code has a built-in SSH terminal that I'm going to use. I connect it to the system, I run bash, and I want to activate Conda environment. This environment contains several utilities from Rocket OpenAppDev that we will use in this project. It is curl to interact with Jira, Git to work with repositories, make for build process, and Vim as an editor. Let's clone the repo from Bitbucket. I got a local copy of the repository in this folder, and now I want to see it via Zoe Explorer. Okay. So this is the project. This is the folder on USS with the source code. And we can find the file with source code. It is here. Make file that describes how to build and how to test the program. In our project, we use Jira as a bug tracker. Let's go to Jira and see what I need to do. I need to rename one field. Let's find it here. Okay, here is it. I do the changes and I want to save file. So this file was updated. And now I want to make sure that we still can build the program and it's still working. I run make. Compilation successfully completed. And now let's test it. Yes, it works. Sometimes I also work on a system that doesn't have an IDE. And in this case, I can work with source code using Vim editor, which is part of Rocket OpenAppDev. I need another SSH terminal to connect to USS. I also can run bash here, activate conda environment, go to the folder with source code and run vim. So you can see here the updated file. I also can do some additional modifications here. And if I want, I can start build process also from this terminal. But for now, we just discard the changes. Let's go back to the VS Code. So we build the program, we tested it, and now I want to add the changes to repository and send them back to the remote repository to Bitbucket, so Craig will be able to pull them in. After compilation, some additional files were added to the folder. Here they are. And before I push them to the repo, I want to make sure that I want to clean them up and to make sure that I am pushing back only source code changes. So I run make again. Yes, we have only one file modified. I want to add it to the repository. Commit the changes. And push them to Bitbucket. Done. Pass the word to you, Craig.
Very good. Thanks, Tatiana. So now I have some work to do. So as you can see, we're here back to the repository. So what I want to do is refresh this real quick and make sure things are nice and fresh. Tatiana mentioned the combination of tools. So I'll be interacting in a different way. I'll be using Ziggy actually to log into like a typical TSO session using 3270, as that's what I'm used to and what I'm comfortable with. But along this path, we'll also be using some other tools. We'll be interacting using some things with curl and other tools and utilities that are available from Rocket Software in the Open App Dev stack. So here, first of all, I'd like to review the commit because we should be able to see in the repository. This is Tatiana's last commit. It was just updated here. So you can see this was the commit that we just worked on. So now what I'll do is I'll log into a 3270 session where I'm comfortable. This is a typical logon. I'm just using a terminal emulation. I'm logging into one of my systems. So the first thing I want to do is I want to show you a little bit of my USS structure. When I log in, you can see, as Tatiana mentioned, she mentioned working in the bash shell and working with some other tools. You can see here that I default into the bash shell. And some of these components as well are listed in directories under my user. So I have access to some of the components as well, but I'll be interacting in a different way. So I'll be using a typical TSO session. So I'll access TSO. To do that, I'm going to use TSO and access Ziggy that we have installed, and I'll be able to use and show you how I can interact with these components in the repository using a typical, more 3270 type session. So this is the repository. You can see the name, COBOL example, and this is our app dev project that we're working on. So I'll select this first one. And then we have, you can see, the name of the SE demo repository. And you can see that I'm behind by one commit. Now, the first thing I need to do is I need to refresh and pull from the remote the most recent updates. So I'll use the tools in Ziggy to allow me to pull from the remote. And now I have everything updated. You see the updates happen. We're behind one commit. Okay. So next thing I want to do is I want to review to see what the changes look like and just make sure that everything looks good and see if I can move forward and compile and retest the program. So I'm going to use option 4 And what I want to see is I want to see the differences here. You can see I have it marked Y. And what I should see is the changes. So you can see the tracking changes. I can see here the process output record and the records under that were changed. And now the value says customer account. So I look at this and I confirm that everything looks good. You can also see the hash here from the, if you remember when we first looked at the Bitbucket repository, it's the same hash. We wanted to compare those. Reviewed the changes. Now I want to be able to access, and I want to use my JCL to recompile and run my compile. So this is the compile for my program. So I'm going to compile my COBOL. And you can see I'm just interacting just like I would normally, but yet I'm using the Ziggy interface. So I've submitted my job, come back with good condition code, so I'm happy. And what I want to do is I want to test it. So this job, again, I access it like I would normally. This is my test job, and then this would be my output file. Okay, this is the compile where my compile pro COBOL program is in my load lib. And I'll submit this. And with any luck, we get all condition good condition code, and you can see here that everything worked correctly. So our test is good. So we're ready to move forward. Let me go back to the repository. So now we've compiled, we've tested, and now we're actually ready to review the changes. So what I'm actually going to do now is I'm going to access Jenkins because we're interacting with the program here in this way. Go here to build with parameters. This is my task ID. And I'm going to issue the build. This is our project. And I'm using Jenkins. So we're waiting for this to execute. Make sure that it executes correctly. And we got everything green here. You can see there, everything's committed. Okay, everything tested. We did the build correctly. Now we're going to access Jira. Now I have a test log. You see the COBOL was successful. Completion of the concludes our demo today. Thank you for watching. And we would encourage you, if you have interest, to visit rocketsoftware.com. If you have interest in the Open App Dev Tools and DevOps toolchain for ZOS. Thanks and have a great day.